I'm Spencer Conlin in Greenwich, where there is a new effort underway to prep, package, and deliver more than 2,500 meals to kids around the community for the duration of summer vacation. Summer break, a couple of months kids get every year to play and spend some time with their families, but for some, it's not so carefree.
I've been home with my daughter since March, since she's been out of school, and our grocery bill has inflated.
Out of work due to the pandemic, Jessica McCulley has run into trouble making sure her third grader has enough food to eat.
The beginning of this, it was like, there's nothing I can do. We're either going to survive or we're going to get washed under.
To alleviate that food insecurity families are experiencing, volunteers are busy this summer inside the high school cafeteria in Greenwich.
250 is a good average of students participating, and then we're doing 10 meals per week, 5 breakfasts, 5 lunches, so about 2,500 meals.
Okay, so we are making up make your own pizza.
Once the food is prepped and sorted, it's delivered right to the student's front door.
And one of the things that people don't realize in rural communities is that those people who are vulnerable are very often unseen.
Sarah Eidelman taught in Greenwich for more than 20 years and continues to find ways to give back to the community. She calls the experience this summer a rewarding one.
I always get a thank you every single time, and I think people are really grateful for this program.
At the forefront of the effort is Comfort Food Community, a local nonprofit which partnered with Greenwich Central School and Baton Kill Community Services.
We wanted to make sure that it wasn't just needs-based or income-based, because I think there's so many parents that are home because of COVID that have kids, and it just saves time.
The group of volunteers are making use of a $75,000 grant called Nourish New York to support the program.
That's specifically designed to purchase from New York producers, especially dairy producers, to try to soak up some of the shortages that they've been experiencing because of COVID.
It's all work that has reduced some of the pressure on Jessica. It will allow her to focus in on some summer fun with her third grader.
She knows that she has food in the house, and she knows that there's good food in the house, and she can eat just about anything.
The program is set to conclude during the first week of September, when students are hopefully allowed to return back to school. In Greenwich, Spencer Collins, Spectrum News.